I'm Kathryn Uhrich. I'm in the chemistry department here at Rutgers University. My specialty is polymer chemistry. So I work in the chemistry department, but I also work in the School of Pharmacy as well as the School of Engineering in chemical engineering and biomedical engineering.
My name is Wenchen Feng, and I graduated from Tsinghua University in Beijing. I'm in Department of Chemistry and Chemical Biology. I'm a second year grad student. I'm working on the polymer drugs project. And so these polymers will break down under physiological pH environments. And they'll break down into bioactives, and these bioactives will be released in a controlled manner.
I'm Jeremy Griffin, coming from WPI up in Worcester, Massachusetts. I have a bachelor's degree in biomedical engineering. I'm in the biomedical engineering program here at Rutgers. I'm entering my third year. My specific project has to do with these polymer drugs, but for the application of nerve regeneration. So essentially, we're making small, tiny casts for broken nerves or that degrade upon in the body and release these active therapeutics.
Well, my name is Roberto Delgado Rivera. I come from the University of Puerto Rico, Mayagüez. I did my undergrad in industrial biotechnology, and I am turned here as a third-year grad student in the chemistry and chemical biology department. And well, I'm in a similar project as Jeremy. It's a nerve regeneration, and basically what we're doing is trying to use these polymers to create matrices that we can implant in the nerves and actually act as a bridge for the nerve to regenerate, and at the same time provide cell guidance to create a better prosthetic implant.
And Roberto does a lot of work over at the UMDNJ Medical School.
My name is Leilani Del Rosario. I'm from University of the Philippines, Los Baños. I got my BS in Agricultural Chemistry, and I'm working on the Polymer Micelle project, which is basically carriers. They're carriers for hydrophobic drugs, such as anti-cancer drugs. So we want the anti-cancer drugs to be delivered to the body through these polymeric micelles, so to increase their water solubility and their therapeutic efficacy.
So it's a wide array of projects, but the commonality is we're all dealing with polymers, which are most people know as plastics. I'll give a short primer on what a polymer is. So a polymer, actually, people know about polygon. Poly means many, mer is essentially unit. So a polymer is unique in that you have many units that are linked together. And the fact that they're linked together, they behave differently if they're linked together than if they're individual components. So this component, for example, if it's a monomer or single unit, has a lot more flexibility. And when you start placing them together, their flexibility is limited, but it has generally very different physical properties. Again, many folks are familiar with polymers also as plastics, but paint coatings, for example, on a wall or on a car, or these are plastics or based out of polymers. And what our group decides to do, or what we decide to do, what we do work on in terms of our research are focusing on polymers that could be used in or on the body, ranging from polymers that can be used to better transport drugs through the bloodstream, to polymers that could be used for nerve regeneration, which these guys are doing, to polymers that can be used to deliver drugs more effectively. Wen Chong is working farther along on a project. One particular polymer we have refer to as polyaspirin. The idea is it's a polymer that will break down into aspirin-like molecules. That polymer was something that had been developed in our lab. We started a company, and now that polymer is used as completely biodegradable cardiac stents and has been implanted into 13 people. For folks who are not familiar with cardiac stents, again, another prop. So essentially what happens if you don't have a good diet or genetics are not on your side, you can get buildup of fat particles basically in the inside of your vasculature. And sometimes what that can do is that those fatty particles can build up, and so it's called occlusion. The blood is not allowed to flow through anymore. And so what they've done is they take something called a stent, which is essentially a metal mesh that the surgeon goes in and uses it. It comes down crimped, and then they use it to kind of fill up or open up that vasculature so blood can flow again. But what they found is sometimes that metal piece can cause problems in the long run because it's metal. You know, your blood vessels are some very, very flexible material. It can cause some issues later on, though, you know, great benefits in the short term. You know, you're preventing a heart attack, you're getting the blood flow, that's most important. but we're trying to see if we can control the longer term effects. So the idea is, instead of a piece of metal, you have a piece of polymer, plastic, that will slowly break down or biodegrade over a period of time. So it has the mechanical properties that will open up your vasculature, let blood flow, and then the right tissue will reform and reheal itself and hopefully form this nice, clean inner vessel, and then that the polymer just needs to go away.